What up?
What's down?
What up, dog? What up, dog?
Wow,
what it do?
Boy, Benny.
It's about that time.
Yes, sir. It's yes, sir.
I'm on here. I'm currently on Twitter. I'm gonna tell y'all what's going on. I'm currently on Twitter arguing with somebody about where our pro day was. Like I'm live. Like, leave me alone. Folks, what's up, y'all? What's up, my guys? What's up, my guys?
You talking about
that
pro day?
That
ain't nobody satisfied with.
I just don't understand why they arguing me about that. They talking about I'm not black because I'm like, what? I don't even know what they talking about.
Yeah, I can't rock with that, bro. Like, every time you say something about a certain individual university, you ain't black. So,
yeah, it's spring game week.
Yes, sir. Yes,
it's
sir.
Spring game week.
What we cooking, G? What we cooking, man?
We start. Look, so
we cooking about that action.
Yeah, about that action, you know. Yeah. You know, I'm ready to get down. I'm ready to get down. We're gonna do a little something up under the tent. You know, we're gonna hook up and do something. I'm excited, bro. I you know, this is the most anticipated spring game just to be back around Arcanites. Yes, I don't think people understand just to be back around family. Like, people don't understand how big of a family this is for Arcan. Man, this is just to be back around family. I'm excited just to get back on campus. Everybody cooking, everybody, you know, having fun, just get back on campus. So that's I'm excited about that. First and foremost.
Hey, G, should I bring my golf cart?
You could.
Hey, we gonna vlog it, man.
Yeah, we're gonna do all that. Vlog, we're gonna try to do a live video. We're gonna try to do it up. We're gonna be in the building.
No, definitely. Let's vlog it. Bring the golf cart, go around there, talk to a few people, you know. Let's do it up.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Benny got the 20s on the golf cart.
But yeah, spring game. I want to pull this up, man. I want to give a big shout out to just our administration, Cook, Miss Kalanda, our first lady, the football team, for the events they putting together for these kids. So I want to give a big shout out. Some of the events they had. Monday it was karaoke. Tuesday it was a stroll off 3-on-3 tournament, like Rucker Park. It was out there like Rucker Park, you know what I'm saying? A domino tournament tomorrow, a pop-up game on Friday. The 2014 team gonna be getting having like a banquet when it is Saturday. And then
I Golden Foot, watch yourself.
Golden Foot in here. And then it's gonna be an alumni flag football game before the game. We're gonna autograph sign it. So shout out to the university for just making this an event, this a big event. In the past, I kind of caught us out for not doing things like this. But I think it was nice that they did this for the kids, and the kids are enjoying it. They're coming out. They even had a concert. Y'all want to start there?
Yeah, let's start with the concert, man.
Let's start with the concert.
We ain't had no Braves Fest in so long, bro.
We've had a Braves Fest this year, and it was headlined by none other than Boosie Badass.
what's the chick name? I don't know a single song by.
K. Michelle.
Yeah,
her.
K. Michelle.
I don't know
K.
a
Michelle,
single song.
Yeah. Hey, shout out to Boosie for coming out, man. But we got to get him some pronunciation classes.
No, hey, they got him right.
Hey, nah, but then he tripped me up. He said, Acorn head ass Boosie. I mean, you know what? It ain't no hope of correcting that, man, but it looked like he had a good time, though.
Boosie know what it's called, man. Boosie been out there when I was out of school, man.
He been out there so long. And then, you know, he had the video with Coach. Shout out to Coach Fred. Coach Leroy. His most memorable moment of the Southern was the Alcorn game with the fans saying, Al McNair. So that's one of his most memorable moments, man. It just shows you how big of an effect that Steve McNair had on the culture. Right. You know what I'm saying? I tell them all the time, I'd be anywhere in the airport, and they'd be like, hey, ain't that the school that Steve McNair went to years later? That's 30 years ago. You know what I'm saying? So shout out to Boots for coming down. But yeah, we gotta get him that, get that pronunciation right. You know what I'm saying? And y'all gotta understand, I'm a Baton Rouge kid. I'm a 90s Baton Rouge kid. So, you know, Boosie was our everything coming up. So to see him at Alcorn too, you know, that was special for me. I was excited. If I wouldn't have been at work, I would have been there. I was gonna be in there with them kids.
Like I said, these kids know blues, Boosie. They don't know Boosie.
Yeah, yeah, they don't know.
Nah, I ain't gonna say that, bro. I got a brother out there. He know Boosie. He play any Boosie song, man. So some of the kids grew up on Boosie. I mean, he riding their pop's car. You know what I'm saying?
I walked outside. I'm tired of this, man. Yeah.
But yeah, he had a good time, and he showed a lot of love. We even gave Boosie some gear, bro. And the next day he put it on. He out there fishing. He got his all corn football gear on. I said, one thing about old Boo gonna wear it. You know what I'm saying? So the next day he was out there with his all corn gear on. So shout out to Boo, just for showing love. And I think the kids had a good time. So shout out to the administration just for getting it down. Cause I can tell you this now, Boo's ain't cheap.
No. And look, and then agreed to come back for a game, man. So
Yep. I can tell you that right now. Boo's ain't cheap. I know that for a fact.
Oh no, he ain't cheap at all.
And so I want to show y'all this. I talked about a 3-on-3 tournament was tonight.
You got some highlights?
Well, they just announced the winner. Let me show y'all who the winner was. Look at your 3-on-3. Look at your 3-on-3 winner of the 3-on-3 basketball tournament. Coach Landon Buss and his assistant coaches. They won the 3-on-3 tournament.
Coach T,
that's great. Coach T, all right, now, Coach T, now, Bussy, my boy, but we need you to win them tournaments in Birmingham too, my boy.
Yeah.
I was gonna, hey, G, it's funny. I was gonna say that, but then I was like, nah, this ain't the time to play.
Yeah, this is my boy. I probably can say what others can't say because it's my boy.
He said this is a tournament to be winning.
But shout out to him. I heard he was out there doing them up. And they had a good time. Look at Devin. You can see Devin Dawson in the back, like they enjoying themselves. So shout out to him. My head coach, Coach T, in the picture too. He got in the picture. I don't know if Coach T played now. Nah. Don't look like Coach T got no.
Nah, Coach T was coach.
Coach T got
some.
What them? Oh, them Kane forward.
Coach T go out there old school on you. You don't need to change no shoes.
He was out there, coach.
I heard Coach T was a good point guard back in the day, too. So,
they say. That's what he said.
Mm-mm.
Man. Yeah, man. Jermaine Taylor won the MVP. Okay. Jermaine. Coach T was the commissioner.
No, okay. Huh?
Okay.
What's up, Wayne Head? Coach Taylor,
Coach D1. Hey, if y'all ain't seen the interview, man, go watch.
Yeah, I was going there.
Go ahead. You go to there. I'll be talking too much. Go ahead.
I was going there, man. Listen, if you guys have not seen Coach Taylor's interview, man, please go and watch it. What's the name of the podcast? Fan something.
Yeah.
But anyway, man, it's about 2 hours long. It's worth every second, man. He dropping some gems. The guys that's interviewing him, man, they're very in touch with the HBCU sector, as well as, how hard it is coming from New Orleans, man. I don't stay in New Orleans, but I grew up down there. I had a bunch of family down there, my grandma's sisters and brothers, West Bank. But, man, for real, that interview, that was dope. The Fan View Podcast, there it is.
Yeah. And it was dope. I watched every second. Let me tell y'all, I watched it. And see, I caught it late, right? I'm going to tell y'all, this is me family, so I'm going to tell y'all the truth. I'm getting dressed to go out. This ball 11 o'clock at night. I'm finna pop out. I'm putting, put me some clothes on, finna pop out. It come across my phone. So my partner sent me like, gee, where you at? I done got out of the shower. I'm sitting there watching the podcast. I keep telling them, I'm around the corner. I'm on my way. I'm coming, but I'm sitting. I ain't never left home. I'm sitting there watching the podcast, and I watched every minute before I left. I mean, every second. I'm a Louisiana boy, so a lot of that stuff touched home for me. Some of the things they're talking about, some of the schools they were talking about, touch home for me. I'm from up the street in Baton Rouge. Even the park, Wayne here talked about Digby Park. I done hung out at Digby Park and had my little nephew down there playing ball at Digby Park. So I got family stay right out there off of Virgilian Street. So, yeah, man, it hit home. So if y'all haven't seen the interview, go check out the interview. And I say this all the time, because Wayne here gonna be a head coach one day.
Most definitely,
that's a head coach in the making.
Most ain't gonna be able to recruit anybody he wants.
Anybody, because he got me.
He ain't gonna get him.
He got me. he got me right now. If I was 80, that's my head coach today. Easy, he already got me. But yeah, shout out, man. But let's go into it, man. Spring game Saturday, bro. What time you making it down?
I'm gonna be there early, man. Y'all know.
All day event, man. I want to be there by 8 o'clock.
I don't know about that early. I plan to be there by nine. I thought the banquet was Friday night.
Oh, I got it right here. Hold on, y'all. Hold on.
I think it's that Saturday morning, ain't it?
No, I think they having a meet and greet that Saturday morning.
The meet and greet with the championship team.
That's Friday night.
Yeah.
At least that's what my boy Big Sam Scott. So
he's gonna hey, somebody said Hode ain't gonna be in the spring game.
Hey, listen,
I won't be, but I got a funeral to go to Saturday. So
yeah, so he got an excuse. Yeah. He turned down an excuse, and you know, we granted him permission to miss it. You know, so
he said if we missed, we were fired. So
yeah, I had to beg for my job with my boss. I told him, I said, "Hey man, just suspend me for the first game or something like that."
So yeah, but we gonna hold it down for you.
Yeah, he owe you a favor anyway, man.
I missed that one, so you know, I missed the last break. I really was slipping with my practice in the spring this year. I ain't catch as many as I normally do. I'm gonna get that Friday.
What time
everything
start? What time?
I think 10 o'clock. Let me see. Let me make sure.
I know the alumni game starts at 10.
So the meet and greet gotta be before that.
I think it's after that.
No, I don't know, bro.
The meet and greet at 9 to 10 with the 2014 team. The alumni flag game at 10 to 11. Football staff and team autograph signing 11 to 12, and then the spring game at 2.
Okay. Bro, we ain't even never done anything like this. Though.
We need
like,
to be out there by 8:30.
Yeah, I'm out there early. I'm cooking.
Y'all know how me, Kane, and Junior coming, so you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, shout out to whoever organized this whole spring game setup. I think it's dope to have the old guys come in, then have the autograph signing. That's big for the kids.
Yeah.
And then have the spring game, bro. I can't remember a time we had this going.
Yeah.
Hey,
shout out to whoever was in charge of that. That was a great idea.
You know why this happening, right?
We know, but
you know why this happening, right?
We know, but. I love it, though.
Because we cooking. That's why this happening. We cooking. But shout out to Miss Kalonda, too. That's our first lady football team. I think she has a huge hand in just the student engagement on campus and things like this, man. We didn't have this last year. We had events for the students last year.
Are we gonna be on the home side or the visitor side? I'm sorry, are y'all gonna be on the home side?
I had to be on the field.
Me too. We gonna be on the field. So
I mean, I know that, but I'm saying they are gonna put people on the home side or the visitor side.
I don't know.
Open up the home side, man. Everybody come out, man.
Yeah, it's gonna be wherever you want.
You can go wherever you want.
I think the concession stand will be open on the visitor side.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I think the band gonna be on the visitor side as well. I think they come.
Hey, I seen some videos there. So did some people in that band,
yeah.
Hey, they got a little bag. Hey, I'm willing to bet that Charlie Spiller get in the end zone.
Okay.
Are we betting on the flag football game over or under? I gotta see who all playing.
Yeah, me too. Cause I got to score 17-13.
Yeah. I gotta see who all playing. Bro.
Low scoring.
O versus B. You got the O or the D?
I don't know. I really don't know if it's being broadcasted this year. To be honest with y'all, I should have got that answer before we came on. It ain't hit me.
Coach Taylor, do you know anything about that?
I'm not sure. To be honest, I would think it would be because I know Coach T doesn't mind it. I know in the past, our last. Coach Fred McNair didn't really want it to be streamed, so I think they played a big part in it not being streamed. But that's one of the differences with Coach T that you know they kind of differ there. Coach T doesn't mind it being streamed or anybody watching. You know, like he told us, they don't know, they most don't know they watching no way. So you know, right. What y'all do? So yeah. So I'm gonna get that answer for y'all and let y'all know.
Yeah, I never really understood that why you want to show your spring game. It's like, first of all, you ain't even running the real deep playbook anyway. You running it's real surface level. So like, why wouldn't you want to show a spring game? That makes no sense.
Well,
I mean, everything is surface level, man. It's basic, just alignment. You ain't doing nothing special. Like, just, what's the point of not showing the spring game, man? Folks been without football since, what, November? Like, people want to see football.
You said everything is what?
When surface level is all you got.
you're telling everything. You just said it. Everything is basic. What we do.
Yeah, bro. It's like fans be fiending for football, man. Like, no disrespect to no other sport, but, like, football is king. I mean, it is what it is in this country. So why not show the spring game? It makes no sense, bro. Like, that used to burn me up, bro.
So
like,
I got a partial answer. I'm being told that for sure be on the radio. A roster has been presented for it to be on the radio. So I'm sure the cameras will be out. So it sounds like it's gonna be broadcasted. I got asked for a roster too, and I be having to tell people like. I be having to tell people like, bro, y'all know I kick and scream about all corn, but I ain't got no roster now, bro. Like, come on, bro. Like, what? Like, gee, hey, send me the roster. Like, dog, I might talk loud and do all that, but
hopefully we'll get there where we'll start having a roster.
We ain't there yet. Hold on.
Yeah, bro. Nah, we surface level.
Yeah, God, dog. I'm like, I appreciate the support. Yeah. I appreciate the support, but they ain't sending me no roster. I didn't have people ask me for crazy stuff.
But like, yeah, listen, bro, y'all keep supporting us, and we can get that. We can get closer and closer. We got y'all.
Y'all become members of the channel. You know,
like the stream, share it to everybody, and we can work something out. But till then, we're just giving y'all what we can give y'all.
What you got going on over there?
Hey man, I just have my camera sideways.
Hey, yeah. I say that tea got you doing something.
Nah, man, that's just sweet tea, man.
Yeah.
So let's get into this spring game. Let's get into this spring game. Give me some. What y'all looking to see? What are some points y'all looking to see from the team, or just position battles you looking to see? Let's get into it.
I want to see the camaraderie, the offense. I want to see how they gelling. Because I know it want to be a fast-paced offense. I want to see if they're able to take those plays in and get them in and out with no false starts, no mishaps, no turnovers. That's what I'm looking for. I know the defense is going to be good. So my eyes are really locked in on the offensive side, the offensive line and the quarterback. That's what I'm looking at.
Yeah, I'm with you. For me, it's like you said, efficiency. Yeah. Efficiency, getting the plays in and out for the offense. I'm with you too, Ben. I ain't worried about defense. I am so listen.
Trench play, man.
Not worried about the defense at all. I don't even think about the defense. For me, like you said, quarterback, offensive line. I want to see a young receiver step up and step out, you know. Because that defense coming. So I want to be able to run the ball some, but just get some moving on the defense. I think our defense is doing really good. But I want to see us still be able to move the ball and just how we transition on offense.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it'd be a good time for us to see the different formations too. Go ahead, Trey.
I want
to
see trench play. Can we get some push on our D line? I mean, we know what our D line presents, not just to us offensively, but the whole SWAC. We saw that last year. So, what can we do to get some push on Big Devin Dawson? You know what I'm saying? And the D line has actually dominated, and Malachi hasn't even participated much. So
yeah, that's what I'm like, bro.
Yeah.
That's what's crazy.
And listen, I'm not saying that because the offensive line has taken a huge leap. But still in all, there has been no Malachi Bailey.
Yeah.
And the D-line is doing what it's doing. And, hey, so if we can get some push up front, we do have playmakers. You know what I'm saying? Like, anybody can go to distance. So, yeah, I want to see offensively what can we do versus our defense.
Yeah. What I like to see, man, honest, obviously the quarterback position. I want to see Mako take control of his huddle or take control of the line of scrimmage. Get those guys right and be that vocal leader that I think he can be and will be. I just want to see offensive efficiency. You know, I think when you see spring games, you know, you're not going to see the 65 points and no crazy stuff like that. You just want your offense to make enough big plays to say, you know what, we got something going. Because like y'all said, the defense is going to be tough, you know. And we always say that defense is always ahead of offense in the spring and in fall camp. So they're going to make plays. But you want to make sure that your offense can make enough plays to be like, have you when you leave, like, okay, we might got something going. So that's what I want to see. Also, the receiver core. I think we're real young, but I think we're really talented. I mean, I would say defense, but we know they're coming, like y'all said. So,
and I mean, that defense been together. That defense has been in the same system, going against the offense in a new system, new coaches. So you know, new signal caller. So just I just want to see, like you said, make up with the turnovers. To be honest with y'all, to start camp, Mako had a few turnovers. And he improved through – I mean, not camp, through spring. And he improved through the spring. So I want to see him keep that up, just taking care of the ball, being able to just take that check down.
Part of the game.
That's the real part of the game. That's what I want to see. We don't have to force nothing. And also the running back position. Sewell had some big runs in the last scrimmage. I know the defensive line was doing it, but at times the offensive line got some push and Sewell was able to bring some big ones.
That's why I'm excited, man. That is why I'm excited.
Y'all didn't see the new guy. I don't even know his name, but he was wearing 31 in practice.
Yes, there is.
Yes.
He missed it.
We find backs everywhere, bro.
He missed it. I'm like, who is this guy?
Yeah, this dude right here coming, bro. I don't know his name, but he is coming. So, yeah. He gonna be nice. If he keep it up, he gonna be nice, and they gonna give him a shot because I know how Coach T mind is, and he don't deviate from. If you're a good player, he don't care about all that other stuff. He ain't playing politics with the game. He gonna put you in. So if Buddy keep it up, man, he gonna get a shot.
Yeah, and like I said, he looked real good that scrimmage, man. I mean, without saying too much, bro, he was running.
Hard. He was running.
Hard.
He dropped that shoulder on somebody. I was like, ooh.
Yeah,
people gotta understand, we still got Fred Davis coming in.
Yeah, it was rough.
So we got the talent. Somebody asked, do we have a special team coach? I just found out that Welch will be our special team coordinator.
Oh,
Derrick Welch, Coach Derrick Welch.
Oh yeah, no more fair kick.
That's some energy there, boy.
Don't call no fair kick.
So you laughing? That was said at practice.
I know.
Literally.
You laughing. They said, literally. No fair catches.
Don't call fair catch.
That doggone Hope was like, yes.
I know. Hope knees probably got weak. Oh,
bro, I was tight. I was so hype, dog.
Gee, I wish you could have saw Hope out there, man. Golly, I wish you could have saw him.
Bro, I was like a kid at a candy store, bro. It was just the vibes and just seeing the offense, bro. Like, come on, bro. It was cool, man. Like I said, I was so appreciative of being there and just seeing it firsthand, bro. I was like a kid at candy store.
But that's why I tell people to come out and support, because the energy around this program. I tell people all the time, everybody want to ask me what I think we're going to do this year. I tell them, honestly, I don't know. We never can really give y'all a 100% answer. But what I can tell you is that the process is better.
Yeah.
And that's what has me confident, that the process, the way things going is better. You know what I'm saying? I'm not knocking or whatever, but I was there the last couple of years. The process is no complaining. It's no moping. We're getting help from the administration. The process is much better. And when the process is good, we can have a streamline to success. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we were winning in the past, but the process wasn't good. So I knew in the back of my mind, this may not be sustainable.
Right.
But if the process is good, we can have sustainable success. And I can tell y'all for sure that the process is going fine. The recruiting is going good. The practices, everyone's demeanor around the program. I love the energy around the program. I ain't seen this kind of energy since 2013. I'm telling y'all.
Speaking of recruiting, we not done.
Oh, yeah, we ain't done. We're gonna have some recruits on campus this weekend. So, you know, we ain't done just yet.
We ain't done yet.
So I wanted to ask y'all this, man. If y'all had to – y'all been to a couple practices, I've been to a couple practices, a couple scrimmages. If y'all had to give a player of the spring, right, award, who you get? I'm going to start. I'm giving mine to Devin Dawson.
Yeah.
I'm giving my defensive tackle, Devin Dawson. He been a great leader, dominating the inside. He been unblockable on the inside, disrupting plays. Devin Dawson for me. Devin Dawson for me, man.
I'm gonna go to another player.
All right,
Edwards, number three.
Oh, Steve, you right.
Yeah.
Steve, linebacker.
Yeah.
He been having a monster spring too.
Yeah.
Steve. Hey, Steve will break out unit swag. Remember the names, the Marion Edwards.
All right, so I'm going offensively, man. Mr. Catch a Slant and Take It 70. I'm going Yoon, bro.
Tyron Warner.
I'm going Yoon, Tyron Warner.
I said, and he, yo.
Hey, bro, that dude.
That dude's special, bro.
Yeah.
Bro, listen.
Listen, Coach, I'm gonna say it now. Coach Phillips told me last year. He was like, G, that dude, you he told me straight up, you've been talking about all these other receivers. I'm telling you, Tyron Warren gonna be special. He said he gonna be special. And that's when I knew. Go ahead, my bad. I cut you off.
I told y'all from the jump.
You did. He been special. Him and 82 been my favorite two receivers in the spring.
I didn't realize Hume was that fast though, man.
Them long legs, got the long stride.
Yeah, he got long stride.
But it's like he showed me a gear before he kicked the stride in, and I was like, "Whoa!"
Trail. I got a question. How many times you can sing somebody outrun Bassfield speed?
That man ain't from Bassfield.
Right, he played against Bassfield.
True. Man, nobody care about no damn Bassfield.
And he outran.
He's not gonna say Bassfield. He's not give a damn about no Bassfield.
Hey, put that down.
Hey, G, it's all right. They couldn't.
Miley walked all them boys. We might have walked all of them.
Yeah, hey.
Ben, hey, I beat y'all in baseball.
These men can whoop a mitt, so hey, mitt. Whatever y'all pronounce that shit.
I beat y'all in baseball.
We represent that woo over here.
Oh, yeah, everybody will beat them, though.
Hey, whoa, let's slow down, buddy. Let's slow down.
I'm playing, bro.
slow down, buddy. It's my second home.
I'm playing, bro.
Shout out to my boy Marquise Warford. I was watching on Facebook. Marquise Warford was coaching track, and man, he was coaching. You know what I'm saying? I was like, look how far my boy Marquise Warford then came. So shout out to
him. Hey,
he's doing real good with the youth and just developing their talent down there in Wilkinson County. So shout out to 10.
I got to talk about 10. He was supposed to be at Amon County, but he reneged on
us. I would have reneged too.
Hey, you see what happened when he reneged? 48-0. That's what happened. Nah, man. He's my boy, bro. That's my guy for real, man.
Yeah, straight up, bro.
That's my guy.
Real stand-up guy. I'm going to go with my player for the spring, bro. I'm going to go with Damian Jones. I'm not going to tell you what position he play or what he do. That boy bad. Y'all ain't got no position he play. Just when y'all hear the name in the fall, y'all be like, dang, that's who he was talking about. Kid special.
That, hey, when you think about Alcorn and this certain number.
Don't even say the number. Nope. We ain't going to say a number. Nope.
Just say he got a special number.
We ain't going to say what he played.
Hey, I was like, he got a special number.
Special number. Hey, Spiller, can we get you on the show this weekend?
Hey, bro, I sent him the link. He don't want to come on.
Hey, man, Spill.
Hey, bro, this episode will do numbers if we get Spiller on here, bro. Come on,
man, we need the GOAT on the show, bro.
Yeah, bro, you can't say Alcorn football without Spiller, bro.
We need my organ player on the show.
I know he's going to be there this weekend. We're going to have a live interview with him this weekend.
I'm playing Pee Wee basketball in a church league, and Charlie Spiller walk in. I feel like I'm praying in front of Michael Jordan or something.
Yeah,
that was like, bro.
I told y'all I used to walk around Baton Rouge with a shirt that said Charlie Spiller, the Jaguar Killer.
Man,
for real, man.
That's
but crazy. Yeah, man. I'm excited. So my player of the spring is Devin Dawson, 59. He been starting since his freshman year. He got there in what, 2020?
Yeah.
So I think that's big for him just to stay around the program. Just to stay around the program for this long, been a starter of four. You don't see that often in HBCU football no more. A 4-year starter sticking around for his senior year. You know what I'm saying? For his final year. Didn't hit the portal. And was getting phone calls, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to Devin Dawson for the work he's been putting in.
Hey, he was getting the offer.
Yeah. A lot, I found out a couple of our players, Blake, you know I got you. Yeah, shout out to Devin Dawson, man, just for sticking with the program. You don't see that often. He's been an anchor on that defense, and sometimes the inside guys don't get the love that the outside guys get. But that's who keep Malachi getting the one-on-ones. It's Devin Dawson in that middle eating up the space.
Even Devin Dawson, man, play at that side. Keep your linebackers clear. Yep. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So.
But I'm also ready to see special teams as well, bro. I want to see how the special teams go.
I will say this: we much better. Now they were kicking, when we were out there, we were kicking in like a 20 mile per hour wind.
I was just gonna say that. Hope.
Yeah, but it looked decent. You know what I'm saying? Like if the wind wasn't going so hard, then we probably would have been pretty. You know what I'm saying? Probably would have been some pretty good kicks. But shout out to Noah, man. Noah hit a field goal, man, into the wind. Yeah.
Shout out to Noah, man. He's also a new member of the 1871 Collective. So shout out to Noah, new member of the 1871 Collective. That gives me – that brings – great segue, guys. That brings me to my, you know, to the time to drop these – pay some bills, okay? The 1871collective.com. Make sure you check out the 1871collective.com where we support our athletes. Also, I'm rocking my Edwin Summerall hat. I got on the Ed Summerall NIL hat. I got the Ed Summerall. I got the shirt somewhere. I bought the shirt too. I got the hold on, here you go. I got the it's 25 Ed, big Ed Summerall. You know what I'm saying? So you know, I got the
That's
25, up, you know what I'm saying?
That's what's up.
I'm gonna put the link in the description of this video. So make sure y'all go support our athletes that are trying to earn them some cash. They play for our entertainment, so I think that's the least we could do is try to support
them. Ed brings the manager, man.
Yeah, he do. He got that confidence.
Hey, he a menace, bro. He had me dying in the scrimmage.
I got the Malachi Bailey gear as well, so make sure y'all support him. Put all of
mine is on the way.
Okay, 25 had a good. I'm gonna make sure y'all put out. I'm gonna put the links and all that into the description of this video. So make sure y'all go check out the 1871collective.com if you can. Just go to the website and become a member. It just can help us do some nice things. We're working on some things, and we can really use a few more supporters. Also, and I got invited to be a part of a big time party. So you know, we tailgate on the yard. I'm gonna play this video, then I'm gonna talk about it after this.
The Smoke Tailgate Crew presents the HBCU Tailgating Experience Reunion. You don't want to wait till football season to roll to smoke. You don't want to miss this. We are calling out the grown and the sexy. We are calling all social clubs, trail riding clubs, tailgaters, and HBCU supporters. Meet us there. Doors open at 8, 1618 Main Street, Vicksburg, Mississippi. The only place to be on Memorial Day weekend.
Oh. Yeah, so it's Memorial Day weekend, the tailgate crew. That's the big tailgate crew. I'm gonna tell y'all now. The tailgate crew take care of me. We was at USM last year, and he invited me to the tailgate. And so this is a tailgate crew. They have people from Jackson, Grambling. They tailgate for big games, man. They come out to they invited me over for the USM game last year, and I walked into the game full and leaning to the side. I walked in leaning, you know. So they take care of some really good food. You can get some alligator, all kind of food, ribs. I think that's the best tailgate crew in the SWAC. Where they throwing if you're an HBCU person, Memorial Day weekend, Vicksburg, Mississippi, come out and just have some fun. I'll be there. Let's get it started. It's like a kickoff party for all our school to talk a little noise, meet up, and let's have a kickoff party. But man, I can't wait. Shout out to my boy Michael Winfield and my boy Omar Mitchell. Shout out. Go ahead.
Speaking of alligator, man, tell the folks what happened when you went to Route 61 and got some gator bites for the first time.
So I sit down at Route 61, right? I was coming from the UAPB and Alcorn game, right? And so all I was hearing was Trail talk about alligator bites. He's like, every time Trail talk about, like, hey, I got alligator bites on me, he'll tell somebody alligator bites on me. So I gotta try these alligator bites, man. So I sit down, right? First, I order my drink, and then I say, listen, let me get some of them alligator bites. So she bring them quick. Listen, I had my kids with me, they would reach and give me that plate. What you doing? Look, so we about to fight at the table over the last one. I'm like, look, who paying? Who paying? Okay, well, I'm gonna get the last one. Since I'm paying, I get the last one. the way to like, boy, you low down for eating the last one from your kid. So they got food coming, give me an alligator bite. But yeah, man, them alligator bites. They the truth, bro. They the truth.
Well, definitely.
But yeah, man, if you can come out and support my guys.
Hey, Mike Reed, you boy, I'm gonna leave you alone though.
What Mike Reed talking about?
He said we're going 5-6, bro. Hey, actually,
Mike said that last year. Mike Reed said that last year.
We got 12 games, Mike, so you gotta have
We can listen, we can't address nobody that can't beat us now.
Don't entertain Nick.
Come on, Mike.
yeah, man. So make sure if y'all can get out to Big Spurman City Memorial Day weekend. And let's come together and have some fun for a cause. I think that's all the bills I gotta pay. But
them two.
Also, my bad. Also, what did I just do? Also, 2024 Celebrity Golf Challenge. If you're interested, sign up. The Golf Challenge has a really good Celebrity Golf Challenge, May 4th, 2024, down in Biloxi, Mississippi.
I've been swinging, G. Just got my draft.
I need to start practicing.
Hey, bro. I ain't doing no type of golf.
No, sir. I'll support.
Catch me on the ninth hole drinking.
Me too.
whatever hole we sponsoring, just catch me that.
Yeah, bro. I'm on that hole the whole time. And when you make it to the hole, we can give you a good laugh. We're just going to talk. Mm-hmm. I ain't playing no golf.
Right-handed, right-handed, or left-handed.
Hey, Mike, you made your church donation yet for y'all basketball coach?
Them folks gonna go bankrupt. Like, also, my thing is, you average 200 people a game, and you try to pay somebody.
I'll stop, man.
4 years.
Leave them alone.
What a math.
We gonna chill out.
We ain't bringing that over here.
Yeah, I don't address people that can't beat. You know, you can't beat the team that lost to Texas Southern last year. I'm not addressing it, but you gotta beat a team with a winning record. You beat one team with a winning record. Why would I waste my time addressing that? And Mike, my boy, but Junior Day is also Junior Day. So you know, any juniors, have them sign up and bring your juniors. I know a lot of times. Why did I got this up like this? Like, I know a lot of times we hear, oh, they not recruiting my kid, or we want this kid walking out in my backyard. Well, these are the times to bring these juniors out and meet our staff. Let the staff get the information on them, bring them out to the junior day, have them sign up, bring them out to the junior day, and let the coaches evaluate them. Then it's no excuse. You know, bring them out because if it was Mississippi State junior day, you'll take them up there.
Right.
And then when Mississippi State don't offer you, like, well, Alcorn didn't offer, but you took your butt up to Mississippi State and USM Junior Day. Well, we got Junior Day Saturday. Yep. We got Junior Day Saturday.
I'm going to take it even further, bro. A lot of guys, especially with this transfer portal, a lot of high school guys, you got to really look at the situation. If you ain't getting no offers from them big schools, because they probably going to the transfer portal. So if you're an in-between guy, like you like a 2-3-star, according to recruiting sites, come to junior day, because I mean, if you got a little bit of talent, I mean, you're gonna get a chance at Alcorn, man. Like,
yeah.
The coach is gonna work with you, you know what I'm saying? It's a family environment, even if you don't excel on the football field, you excel in the classroom and in life. So, come out to junior day. If you feel like you're getting overlooked, come out to Alcorn. We ain't gonna overlook you,
yeah. Because, like, a lot of people, no, I take a lot of the blunt for the coaching staff. Why they ain't recruiting my nephew? But I sent you this flyer, ain't nobody getting back with me, ain't nobody saying nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So you mean to tell me when it's time to start offering players, we gonna overlook the ones that want to be at Alcorn for the ones that's looking at Mississippi State right now? And then when they don't get Mississippi State, they want to come back to Alcorn? That ain't how that works.
Yep.
I want the girl that want me. I don't know how y'all was built, yep. But I want the girl that want me. I'm not a rebound, and Alcorn can't be a rebound.
I don't like being used. I don't like it at all.
No, I don't like being used either.
Yeah, if you ain't got no interest, just don't.
See, that's the problem.
What? See, this is the type of stuff. Alcorn recruit type. This is the type of stuff. This is what I mean. Alcorn doesn't recruit Vicksburg.
That's a lie, too.
He ain't never heard J.D. Kelly.
What? He?
I can't.
Grambling, bro.
What?
Leave it.
Wait, listen. Bro, we go to Vicksburg first.
The same
the
way
first Keenan stop every year Vicksburg. Every year.
I let that go.
We offered a DN from Vicksburg, a receiver from Vicksburg, a defensive tackle from Vicksburg, a cornerback from Vicksburg this year.
Woo. The last
people act said. Like because you recruit them, they have
this is the former head coach at Vicksburg High School. Yep. And what and LIE, yeah, that mean lie. Okay. Lies. We can't come on here. We can't come we cannot come on here expressing them lie. And I gotta give a shout out to Ty McDaniel because this is Ty, shout out to Coach Ty McDaniel.
Legendary coach.
Legendary. Because he embodies what it means to look out for your HBCU.
Yep.
So that door, wherever Ty McDaniel is, that door is always open for all corner, all HBCU. You know, some coaches, you know, I'm passionate about this. You know, some coaches, you know, they try to push their kids certain places. Ty gonna get the same respect to Cedric Thomas that he gonna get a Nick Saban. The same respect. The same list of players. To Eric Dooley that he gonna give to Nick Saban, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to him. We need coaches like that push HBCUs and tell the kids that HBCU are just as good as these other schools y'all looking up to. So shout out.
And not only that, he a hell of a coach, man. He's won everywhere he's been, and he develops talent. So
just saying,
remember that name,
Hazelhurst.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Vicksburg, Hazelhurst, not originally, man. Like,
ooh, yeah, he needs to know some
guys.
A program builder.
For him to keep that door open, that's big time. So
I'm an all-core fan. I'm telling you what I see. You telling what you see, and I'm telling you what I know.
Right.
Now, I might not have the list of rosters, but I got the list of people we recruit. Okay, we get the list of the people we recruit. And I'm telling you, we recruit high school kids. I'm going to give y'all a story, and I'm going to leave this alone. I've saw kids in Vicksburg. I'm gonna tell you the truth. In Vicksburg, we had our DC a couple years ago go to Vicksburg trying to recruit a kid. The kid tells the coach that he's not in school. So our DC goes to the school anyway. Guess who's walking around at school when he gets to the school? Then the kid that told him that he wasn't at school, that you couldn't talk to him. The kid loses all his offers. Guess who in my DM saying Alcorn didn't recruit him? That kid. So I didn't know this, right? So I hit the coach and I'm like, Coach, hey, this kid, he's playing sixth grade. He like, gee, I went to the school. The kid lied and told me he wasn't there because he thought he had all these other offers. Well, all these offers fell, and now Alcorn didn't recruit me. That goes on a lot. We send these kids letters. We DM these. The coach DM these kids. They don't respond because they think they're too good for Alcorn. They think they're too good for HBCUs. And then after we didn't build a relationship with these kids, they didn't think we were too good. You know, we gave them the offers. They come back and go, oh, they didn't recruit me. No, these kids been showing interest in Alcorn, visiting Alcorn, doing all this work with Alcorn. We gonna pull they offer to give to you when you overlooked us? No, that ain't how it go.
Nah,
dog. That ain't how it go. That's not how it go. And I can tell you firsthand.
Nah, dog.
Chris Martin committed. Chris Martin picked up offers after Alcorn. He the type of kid, but he was showing interest in Alcorn. So we show interest back. That's right, how they go.
He wanted to
Where
be
he from? Devin Dawson.
He not even from Atlanta area, bro. He from
Trump
like
Griffin.
He from Southern Georgia.
High school kid.
JD Kelly.
Vicksburg.
Vicksburg. Don't get on here talking because you don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, when it comes to recruiting, this is what I know now. This is what I might not, you know, but this recruiting is what I know. This is what I do. This is what I do now. We offer more out of Mississippi than anywhere.
We might tell you a joke. We ain't going to tell you a lie.
I ain't going to tell you no lie about that now. I ain't going to tell you no lie about that. But, yeah, we're not going to get every – some kids want to get out of Mississippi. Some kids want to get out of Vicksburg. I'm from Baton Rouge. I ain't never when the Southern recruiters came to my high school, I swear to God, it's a true story. You know what I told them people when they were talking about Southern? I looked that lady in the eyes and told her, I've been to high school once. I don't want to go to high school again. You know what I'm saying? I've been around Southern all my life. Some kids want to get out. You know what I'm saying? And you can only respect it. But yeah. they need to start telling y'all the truth. Like, a lot of them, we in their DMs and we sending them emails and they're not getting back with us because USM flirting with them.
Here's my question. So Michael Winfield, just because a student signs with another school means that the school that they're closest to didn't recruit them?
That's what it sounds like to me.
That's what they think.
And listen, sometimes we're gonna miss a few kids that's close. Yeah. Sometimes We, you know, sometimes that happens. You know how many Florida boys we got on our team? That means, fam, you ain't looking. You know what I'm saying? So it just how the game goes.
It just depends on the individual kid and so what their purpose.
I guess he think there is nobody from Baton Rouge on Grambling's team.
It's full of Baton Rouge folks.
So Southern ain't recruit.
Just like it's full of kids from this area.
I'm telling you,
they go to Southern.
They ain't hear from us. We may have 20 scholarships a year, right? And we talking about thousands of kids.
Listen, what do you think?
You know how many kids gonna say they heard from Alcorn? My God,
a whole bunch of them ain't gonna be there.
One, and then two. You got, but I ain't mad at you, Marquise, because I was you before I started talking to these kids. These kids lie. I lied as a kid. I lie as an adult. You know what I'm saying? These kids lie. I'm telling you a story of what a kid told a bold-faced lie to a coach and then came told me that Alcorn was recruiting him. This coach showed me the proof that he went to the school.
Yeah.
It to try to visit his kid and offer this kid. The kid told the coach he was not at school.
Grambling is a national brand.
Let's be real. Man, don't get me started. This ain't a Grambling show, so I ain't gonna say that.
Everybody ain't D1 material neither. Let's just be real.
Hey, hold up, and let me say this. Everybody don't qualify.
That's what I'm saying. You're not D1 material. So
that's a lot of the issues. A lot of people say, and I can't believe such and such ain't recruit them, but the kids go JUCO. It's the reason. Mm-hmm. They ain't going to JUCO because they want to.
And some people's standards just different. If one thing, like Wayne here was saying, if I can't get on the phone with your mama, if we can't sit down and have a streamlined conversation, I don't care if you want a 4-3. When I come talk to you, you can't complete sentences with me, I'm not gonna recruit you.
Facts.
You know.
I think a lot of people, like I said, I've been saying this the whole show, surface level thinking. They look on the outside, they look on rosters, and you don't see certain kids from certain areas, and you think they don't recruit. That's not the case, bro. Because, like, I can say this in the Jackson area, and I'm going to say this. This is the last thing I'm going to say. A lot of kids don't want to go to Jackson State. I'm just going to be honest. They don't. They want to get out of Jackson. So you can't fault certain – and then same for Alcorn and the whole Port Gibson and Fed area. A lot of kids want to get out of that. So you can't use that as your narrative that a school don't recruit that area just because their roster don't have kids
exactly.
From
there. And I know kids that didn't want to come to Alcorn because it was too close to home, went up the street, and now they're in everybody's inbox trying to get back to
Alcorn. I know a plenty. Listen, man, I'm going to show y'all because y'all got me high with this. I love to let y'all get. I want to show y'all.
The most sweet tea.
Hey, I'm gonna show y'all my inbox.
But then also,
these are kids.
Yeah.
Look, let me show y'all. These are just kids. These are nothing but recruits now. And I'm not a coach. This is me.
I had to stop it.
This is me. Oh, this is me. It's so many kids, bro.
But see, that's the thing about me, bro. Like, kids reach out to me as well, but I'm so honest with them. I be like, look. Don't come at us after you've been dumped around and tossed around. You know what I'm saying? I want us to be your first option. I want you to really think about us as your first option. Don't come at us after UAB, USM, then dumped you. Don't come
at us. Listen, this is my thing. This is my last thing I'm going to say about this. I think it starts at 10. But this is my last thing I'm going to say about this. Y'all really think these coaches getting paid to recruit, right? This is their livelihood. You really think they are intentionally missing out on good players? Because they from a certain area.
No.
You really think you know more about recruiting than somebody that gets paid, that's been getting paid to recruit? You really think you know better? Imagine you on your job, you a bus driver, okay? I ain't got my license, and I'm trying to tell you how to drive your bus.
Facts.
That's what y'all do sometimes. That's what y'all do sometimes. These coaches know what they doing. That's all I'm saying, bro.
You just gotta win.
I'm with you, Hope.
Just like with anything, man, the process, bro. You got to trust the process, bro. Like, coaches ain't – I mean, come on now. You got to think about their jobs on the line, bro. You think they're going to miss a good kid on purpose?
That's what I'm saying. And listen,
that's dumb.
Y'all know I don't never take up for Southern, but, you know, Southern hears this a lot, too. And like I said, I'm in Baton Rouge watching these kids go to LSU and Southeast Louisiana and overlook the HBCU. And then when they don't get them offers, what do?
Come back.
Hey, that's not, like when you
now Southern ain't recruiting me.
I'm tired of being used.
You want to at first, but then she want to come back to you after she ain't got no walls.
See, you don't got
time. I ain't got time for that.
She got 7 kids. Like, you wanted her in high school. She ain't want you. You know what I'm saying? Now she got 7 kids trying to come back.
Right.
No walls.
None.
What
time is Jimmy? My kids make
what time is Jimmy? They said.
I think it started at 10 o'clock. I think it's a really all day thing. Where they tour the campus, meet with the coaches, and do things like this. So I think it's an all day thing.
But I think that was a good topic, though.
I think they need to be said. That was
good. It needs to be said, bro.
Y'all went there for real.
Yeah, we did. Man. We did.
I mean, we had to, bro, because that comes up a lot, man.
I hear it every day, and our HBCU struggle with misinformation like that, and so people really run with it. You know what I'm saying? So it's up to people with us, like platforms, to speak out against them and control our own narrative about it.
And then people don't realize how damaging social media is. Yeah. So a kid can get on TikTok and lie his ass off about not getting offers from HBCU, then that gets shown to about thousands and thousands of kids around the country. Yeah. They like, well, HBCUs don't recruit me. Like,
wasn't Malik Franklin from Georgia?
Yeah.
No, Florida.
Nah,
he's corner, you talking
from
about?
Georgia.
No, he's from Georgia. Franklin.
The receiver.
South Georgia. Franklin. DeMari Franklin.
DeMari Franklin. Okay, yeah. I'm thinking, I said Malik this year.
Yeah. I know who you're talking about. Yeah. I think a lot of these people just don't understand scholarships neither, man. It's only so many scholarships you can put out.
Right.
Per year, yeah. Doesn't mean
understand the money side of it. They don't get it.
Yeah, he was from Middle Georgia.
And you gotta hit it with them scholarships. Like
They struck a nerve with that one. I ain't gonna lie.
I think the whole
it was good. It was a good topic though.
Associated with all in Vicksburg. I think that was the thing.
Shout out to Coach McDaniel, man. Appreciate you for being here to clear that up.
That's my guy now. That's my guy. We always chop it up. We always chop it up, man. So shout out to him. Good luck to you over there, Ridgeland.
His brother worked. I think he's still working at McCown.
And you know that's why I love having a platform. I tell this story all the time. I love having a platform so we can tell our own story. You can't talk about HBCU game. They can't talk about can't tell a story about Alcorn first no more. You can't do it. CNN can't tell a story about Alcorn first no more. That's you can't rap. Do it. When I tell people this, when the Coach McNair stuff was going on, listen, this is no lie. ESPN was in my inbox. The news in Jackson was in my inbox. All these HBCU shows was in my inbox. I said, "Ooh, I got them. Ooh, you got to come through me to get the information now."
Yeah.
Ooh, and I ain't telling them nothing. We gonna control the narrative. We gonna control the narrative. So, shout out to y'all for supporting and always supporting the Golden Ham, bro. But back to the spring game.
Hey, man, it's kind of hard to get back on the spring game now.
Hey, I think it's imperative that we do come out and support, though. If you can make it, come out and support, because it's a lot of injury around the program right now, and everything going good. I think another boost would be for these kids to see some support in the stands. I think that'd be real good. I can tell y'all this. This is something else. I keep forgetting to pay for the bills, right? My Baton Rouge alumni chapter just got reactivated in Baton Rouge, the Alcorn State alumni chapter, and we're gonna be doing a split the pot. I think it's $5 split the pot raffle giveaway at the game. So come out there and support the Baton Rouge.
I ain't give you $5.
What we giving away?
You split the pot. How much if we raise? We raise $10, you get $5. You know.
Yeah,
I'm a little slow, bro. I'm a little slow. My bad.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
I'm over here thinking about they giving away a big screen TV or what? What we giving away? But
Cedric Robinson doing real good too. Shout out to Cedric Robinson. Who cooking, man, Saturday? You know, I'm be cooking Saturday. You know.
I can't wait to Cedric Robinson get on campus.
He on campus.
What number is he wearing?
I asked Coach last time
who he was. Yeah, I really don't know the numbers of the new linebackers. I really don't know. So,
I forgot. He told me because he made a play, and I was like, "Who is that?" And he said Sidney Robert. So yeah, I forgot the number though.
That dude gonna be special, bro.
Yeah, he gonna be special.
God.
So yeah, man.
He gonna be my freshman of the year.
Yeah. Shout out. If you can, come out and support. Come out and support. Come out and support the what's the morale around the offensive coaching staff? Man, it's love.
Man,
listen. What I love the most is the competition factor. And they having fun out there, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't know that. You remember that? Remember we had that slogan in spite of.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that 7-4 season we had last year was in spite of a lot of things.
Yep.
You know, and I'm not going to publicly say too much, but it was in spite of a lot of things. A lot of people wanted things this way or thought things should go this way. Not on one accord on the opposite side of the ball. And it's just me being real. Not on one accord. All that is dead. The process is much better. The morale is much better. I can tell you that.
I'm saying, did you notice like the offensive coaches didn't even talk to the defensive coaches?
Yeah, they didn't. They simply didn't. And that's one. Oh, my bad. Trail at the bottom, y'all. My bad.
Lift his ass out. That's crazy.
Every time, right?
Yeah, but like sometimes the defense coach wouldn't even talk to the. It was things like that going on. People did. You know, on the outside you don't see that.
Yeah.
You know, that's why I say it's a new day at Alcorn, and it's a breath of fresh air because all that stuff is cleaned up and the process is much better. So before we can, you know, we were excited about recruiting and excited about this and who coming back. If we didn't fix the process, none of that mattered. We fixed the process first. We fixed the process first.
That thing from top to bottom, you know, the administration is getting along with the staff for the first time in forever.
Yeah, working with them. And, you know, I think it's less complaining. Let's go to work.
Yep.
Let's go to work. And it's going to be some surprises we got coming out. You know, I ain't privy to tell just yet. But it's some surprises that, you know, the players going to be rewarded with certain things. The team going to be rewarded with certain things. You know, it's real. There's some big things happening.
Some big rumors out there, too.
It's some big rumors out there, too. I got listen. You know how it is. When rumors start piling on, I had somebody call me. I got it first about a week ago. But how I do it is I get it first, I sit on it.
I get
it again, okay. That third time I go to ask questions. Hey, you heard this? Mm-hmm. Don't you hear about this? You know what I'm saying? So it's a rumor about us hiring a high profile AD. I'll just leave it at that. So picking up steam, and I've been asked from his side of the party. Is it true? You know, some people that close to him are like, gee, you know, they reached out to me like, gee, I know you know a lot about Auckland. Is this true? So I was telling him, look, I've been told it, but I don't know yet. I can't confirm or deny, just to be honest.
I got a source that's real close to him. I'm going to find some more stuff out tomorrow.
Yeah.
Well, you know, from what I've heard, I ain't plugged in like y'all guys, but either one will be a high profile hot.
Yeah, either one. I think we're in good hands.
Yeah, I'm cool with either one. Yeah, either one, I'm booming.
Yeah. Cook pull either one of them off. He cooking for real.
Yeah, he cooking.
Yep.
Cooking.
Regular salt and season salt.
Hope he can fix the baseball field. I heard that's in the works. Shout out to Mr. Crowell. Shout out to your son as well. Marty sport athlete, linebacker on the football team. You know, also plays on the baseball team. So shout out.
I hate that dude, bro.
What do you? Good question. Really good question. Because the day we get AD, listen, I want to have a sit down meeting with him. A sit down meeting about social, just media and marketing.
Yeah,
I'm taking him to go. I'm taking him to get some Gator Bites. We got to talk.
Just media and marketing. I think we do so much better job of just media and marketing. Like it shouldn't be a question if the game will be broadcast this week. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We shouldn't find it out Saturday morning. If the game will be broadcast this week. You see what I'm saying? That's to be That's something we should know. Also, you know, it could be behind a paywall, or we could charge it. It's just like you said, fundraising, and for me, media, probably because I'm in the media and I kind of see some of the things we lack. You know what I'm saying? I think I was looking at it, and all the things that all the coverage that we got from the spring game came from the Common Man podcast and the Golden Helm Review. There has been no clippings, no coverage from the actual university.
So that speaks on there's no direction. Athletic director, I just want the guy to have some direction. Like, this athletic department has to have some direction. I haven't seen that in years. And that was under Horn and who came after him, Dito, and who we got now. We hadn't had any direction. Yeah. Just lost in the department all the way around.
And I think also Honey Huddle as well. Honey Huddle as well. Shout out. Yeah. And I think also and some of that has to do with funding. So that's why fundraising will be important. But also there aren't any major campaigns, to raise any money. You know, I think this is something we can improve on, just marketing and media. Marketing and media, media presence. Man, anything can go viral. I don't think they understand, anything can go viral and change your life.
Yep.
Did y'all see the dude with I Ain't Fresh? A crazy video like that just blew up. Do you know what would happen if people knew? I don't think people always ask Alkanites, why y'all love Alcorn so much? If they could see and understand a Saturday on a reservation. If they just could see it and understand it, we gotta put that out there. You know what I'm saying? We gotta tell our story. We gotta tell it. You know what I'm saying? I was talking to our former SID just a couple years ago, and he hit me up. He like, man, G, that 2019 video is amazing. He was like, man, the university has none of this. Why am I on Twitter showing the world something that the school can't show? Y'all should be able to capture that moment as well.
All right.
Y'all should be able to capture that. Man, that 2019 moment should be something that's played when you walk. That moment, that 2018, I'm sorry, y'all. 2018 moment.
That was electric, bro. I was just thinking about it.
You don't get that. You don't get that everywhere. And that's something that needs to be addressed. So I think we do it, us as Arcanites do a better job of promoting the Alcorn and marketing Alcorn than the actual university does.
Fact.
Hey, do a better job.
Paul Turner, yeah, man, that's sweet tea from Vidalia, man. It's good.
Also, I think a lot of times, man, even the younger generation, man, like, I know I had cats, younger kids coming to me like, man, why y'all love Alcorn? Like, they watch the show, they're like, man, y'all love Alcorn. I'm like, but then I have to understand the Alcorn that we experience ain't the Alcorn they experience because of the administration, because of all the turnover, you know what I'm saying? So I had to understand why they feel that way. And I feel bad for those kids because they don't understand how a special place Alcorn is, how big of a special place Alcorn really is. Damn, my teeth whooping my ass right now. But anyway, so I think, like you said, G, we got to get it shown in the media and throughout the masses, man, because, it is a special place.
That video alone, I think, is on my Twitter page. I put it on Twitter. And yeah, I think from my profile, it got like 60,000 views. From my profile, you know what I'm saying? Imagine a push from a university marketing department to push stuff like
that. So look, that video of Who Want the Smoke, and then the year, I don't know if that was a homecoming or just a Graham home game when we played them. When SOD started playing Graham's theme song.
Oh, yeah.
Just imagine, have y'all seen from the university a video of just our tailgate section on a Saturday?
Yeah, that is crazy.
People don't get it. Like people hear about the stories, but they don't see it. Just the tailgate, man. You know, we do things different. I tell people we the country capital of the world.
Fact.
We the country cookout capital of the world. Don't nobody do it better. They can't do it better. They don't have the space to do it better. They don't have the people to do it better. Nobody does it better. You cannot do it.
It don't matter who you are. If you come to an Argonne tailgate and you leave hungry, it's your fault.
But we got to do a better job. And we got to do a better job of showcasing it. You know, it shouldn't be a secret. We shouldn't only know that. It's like it's a secret. And I tell people that. Shout out to the Smoke podcast. I see the Smoke group. My bad.
Yo, T whooping your ass too, huh?
My bad. Shout out to the smoke. While I'm here, since
Michael, you finally said something, I agree with you.
Yeah, Michael, I appreciate that, bro.
You all right for that, bro.
You all right.
The Smoke Tailgate presents the HBCU Tailgating Experience Reunion.
Hey, I'll be back.
You don't want to wait to football season to roll with the smoke. You don't want to miss this. We are calling out the grown and the sexy.
I'm in the building, Mike.
Clubs,
Mike, I'm in the building.
Clubs, tailgaters, and
with my hat to the back, Mike.
Meet us there. Doors open at 8, 1618 Main Street, Vicksburg, Mississippi. The only place to be on Memorial Day weekend.
That's the Smoke Tailgate Crew. That's the Smoke Tailgate Crew. I think that's the best tailgate crew in the SWAC, and it's conformed of a bunch of people from around the SWAC that come together, different school, come together and just kicking. And that's what that weekend gonna be. Memorial Day weekend, you know, you ain't doing nothing. Come out and have some fun, kick it with your boy. So
you need to show them that snippet of the homecoming that Jay had.
Oh yeah, I got it.
Yeah, you need to show them that snippet, man. Like, the more we put it out there, man, the more people going to want to be involved and come experience. So,
yeah.
Like you say, we got to advertise.
I think that's what I want to sit down with our AD and get. That's why I also think hiring an AD that understands the culture is important as well.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't want just somebody just good with raising money. You have to understand the culture and understand what Arcanite's going to buy, what Arcanite's going to get into. You know what I'm saying? Somebody understands the culture as well. Yeah. As for you, I think it had to be a mixture of both. Can't be just too much understanding the culture, but he ain't never raised no money before.
Right.
You know what I'm
saying? Right.
Like,
right.
You know, can't do that. You know what I'm saying? Then also can't be too much fundraising buttoned up and don't understand that we trying to get in the game at 2 a.m. for the Jackson State Southern homecoming games. You know what I'm saying? You don't know that. You know what I'm saying? So it's different. I think it's a little bit of both.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Also, man, I don't know who we need to talk to, but when I'm looking for like more like Alcorn merchandise, you will see like no hint to like other smaller or other vendors, but like Fanatics got all types of other HBCUs. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can go there and get a shirt from FAMU or something like that. I think we need to be more proactive with getting our brand out there, because I mean, you go on like Fanatics, like I said. They just to be out there, you know what I'm saying? I'm not saying I'm a buy for Fanatics, because me personally, I like, of course, you know, I like the Anthony Lawrence collection. I got a couple stuff from there.
And then shout out, good plug.
Yeah, I bought a jersey, a baseball jersey and a hockey jersey from there last week. But just getting our brand out, I think that's what we lack.
Hey man, I know you brought up the Anthony Lawrence collection, but I gotta bring my boy Fates up, man.
Yeah. Yes.
Fates, my bad,
Fates.
Yeah, Fates as well.
Fates is an all. He's been dropping some heat.
Fates gonna be at every event. Yeah.
Yes, and Fates, and Fates gonna be not only event. Allcorn, man.
I gotta tell Fates to give me a card.
Yeah.
Did you say about E-Red as well?
So
yeah,
look,
E-Red,
if you need some HBCU apparel, or you need a doggone barrier quote, holler at Jeremy Fates.
Yeah, But like I said, when I said that, I'm not saying that go buy from Fanatics. Or
right,
just saying,
right.
You just need the brand out there so people can know Alcorn State. You know what I'm saying? Because 9 times out of 10, them other schools ain't getting their stuff bought on Fanatics or nothing like that. So it's just, we got to promote the brand more.
Hold on, y'all. I want to bring this up, too. I want to bring this up because I gotta get this shout out. Give me 1 second, y'all. Y'all can keep talking up. I can wait on me, but I got to bring this up.
Man, so, Trail, what you cooking Saturday?
Man, we going to do baby shower food, man, just to be honest.
Oh, man, shower food. You ain't bringing none of them sausages?
Huh?
God dang, man. You
ain't bringing none of them sausages?
You want some, bro?
Hey, bro, those sausages off the chain, dog.
I'll bring you a couple packs, man. I'll bring you some packs.
Hey, I'm gonna try to slide down. Nah.
Hey, man. So look, here you go. I got it up, right? So I gotta give a shout out to this guy right here. Hold on, come on. Happy birthday to Mr. 1871, the CEO, the boss man, the 1871 who make everything go. Happy birthday to my guy, JJ, boss man, 1871 collector. So
happy birthday, JJ.
Shout out to him. Another year around the sun. Love what you do for the Universal. Oh,
happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
So happy birthday to Mr. AT71 Collective. You know, we have the best collective in FCS football. I mean, I ain't gonna say football. In FCS sport, we have the best in all Corn State University, and it's headed by this guy, Mr. JJ Smith.
Athletic.
So shout out to JJ. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you and Miss Melissa, his wife. Appreciate everything you do, how you support the platform. You know, I can always count on y'all to be here supporting. I'm always getting support and respect back. 1871collective.com. My guy, appreciate it.
Hey, Benny Kane say, not to my bell, man. Got you hooked.
Bruh, I was craving for them things.
I got you, bro.
They were good, bro. They really were.
It's different, bro. I'm telling you, it's different.
Hey. Yeah, my bill. But yeah, I'm gonna do me a little throwing down too. So you know,
you said you cook some fish, huh, G?
Yeah, I'm gonna fry some fish. Probably boil some meat.
You gonna do no spaghetti with the fish?
Something.
Man, heck no, spaghetti don't go with fish.
Yes, it do. I'm with Trill.
Man, y'all boys.
Here we go again.
I ain't no spaghetti with this fish.
Oh, my God. Where y'all from, man?
I'm different. Spaghetti don't go with fish. Shrimp don't go in no grits. And chicken don't go with waffle.
Man, that's country, dog. That's country. That's that country thinking, bro.
No.
It's country, bro.
No. But,
I can't do
this pine bill thing. Hey Benny, that must be a pine bill thing.
I don't know, bro. I've never heard a country say that. We ain't doing no spaghetti.
I don't want no syrup on my chicken.
I get you, G. You from Baton Rouge, but Trail?
No,
backwoods.
Trail from Amy County. That ain't too far from from that line right there.
Man,
hey,
so you mean to tell me you ain't never had no good catfish with some spaghetti,
bro? Never. I've heard of it until Alcorn, but I've heard of it a lot. But I've never had it like that ever.
And y'all need to come to my post tailgate. That's all my dad cooked. Spaghetti and catfish.
I'm gonna have my fish on that
light bread.
Oh yeah, I do know about that now.
That's cool too. Hey, they on me, cuz. I don't want no spaghetti with my fish. Give me some hot sauce and a piece of light bread.
That's what I want. That's all I need. That's all I need. I'm good.
So you don't want no garlic bread, bro?
Bring that spaghetti.
No, not with fish, but just spaghetti, bro.
Oh, if I eat spaghetti, yeah. Give me a piece
of light bread. Okay, I'm trying to agree with you on something.
But okay. I don't want no fish with my spaghetti.
I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna tell y'all something funny. I put barbecue sauce in my spaghetti, bro.
All right,
I went to Memphis one time, bro. They had barbecue spaghetti.
Willie, hey, Uncle Willie, I'm calling you Uncle Willie. Uncle Willie say he wants some chicken with his spaghetti.
I agree. Chicken is spaghetti.
Well, y'all boys backwards.
Chicken is spaghetti, yeah, but I ain't never had the fish. Ooh, Spiller, don't do it. You gonna make me get some fish tonight. Ooh. Don't do it to me, Spiller. Fish, potato salad, some light bread. Ooh.
Hey, I ain't eat nobody potato salad.
Come on, Trill, dog.
Now you give me some rice and gravy, we can put it with anything. Anything.
Somebody say get off. Hey, I'm sorry, bro. I had to shout it out though.
I ain't never heard that song, bro. You threw me off with that one.
It wasn't tomato. No, listen. It wasn't tomato sauce. They made the barbecue sauce as like the tomato sauce. I had to get it. And it was pretty good, bro. Like I wasn't damn sure what to eat no tomato sauce and barbecue sauce. I'm just saying, substitute tomato sauce for the barbecue sauce.
No, dog. I can't probably go with fine. It. I can't let you have it. I can't let you have that one.
I'm looking at you like you're crazy right now.
I like spaghetti and I like fish, so I probably can eat that together. I just never done it. You know what I'm saying? I probably can eat it together.
Yeah, I got you. To each barbecue his own, sauce? You know what I'm saying?
I ain't never heard that one.
Oh man.
I can't do that. Give me some potato salad with my fish. I'm going to take that fish hot, dip it in that potato salad.
Hello, Tashay.
I don't know how we going to food, but yes, indeed.
You need some baked beans and dirty rice with ribs. I don't want no potato.
I'd ate it with ribs, too. I'd ate it with barbecue, too. I'd ate it with barbecue, too. Gator bites and spaghetti. But yeah, we're gonna set up.
Go ahead. Maybe my barbecue spaghetti. Okay, I'm sitting in the corner eat my barbecue spaghetti by myself.
Yeah, you're on your own with that one, dog.
Yeah, you're alone. I can't even try that one.
I'm tripping. I ain't got the banner up here.
They make you say like it's some Fear Factor type stuff.
Yeah, you're on your own with that one.
I tell you what, good. Y'all finna call me country. Y'all remember Hamburger Helper? That spaghetti. Boy, you get you a piece of bread with the hamburger. Like your Hamburger Helper.
I ain't never had
that. I don't know about that one.
Yeah, that's the Amy County stuff.
Don't knock it till you try. Don't knock it till you try.
Amy County, that cuz. I just read it.
we're
talking about food.
Y'all know
I got a shot of chicken.
Meatball sandwiches
and he was talking about JJ birthday thing.
Okay. Yeah, I was talking about JJ birthday. Yeah.
Something simple.
My bad, JJ. We went the old segue.
Yeah.
We segue all the way to my crazy.
So I wanna do something for y'all. So we know why. We're gonna do a session right now where you're gonna put in the comments. If you're not coming to the spring game, I need to know why. We need to know why you're not coming, and we as a panel gonna vote if your excuse is valid or not. And if you know if it ain't valid, you gotta get kicked off the Brave Nation.
Let's do it.
Hey, hold on. Let's do it. Before we get on that, bro. Yeah. I'm not going to the spring.
No, you legit, bro. You good.
You're good. Okay. Okay. You good, but you okay. This is how we gonna do it.
No. He already missed the practice.
No.
Damn,
no.
Benny.
Benny, you good, man.
So this is what we gonna do. Hope, I love you, but you ain't got no vote.
How you gonna do that to you, man? And you have to fill in for that, man, bro.
What they say?
Nah, man. I explain. I'm not going to spring game because I have to go to a funeral Saturday. So that's why
he get a pass. Hope get the pass. But I need to.
I feel like I get to vote because, like I said, I feel we. Like Trill said, I did fill in, you know what I'm saying?
You did. So. You filled in. And did some good interviews. If y'all hadn't checked out my boy Hope interviews, and we dropped a video last week, a couple days late, y'all know how I do. With Hope getting interviews. So shout out to Hope for getting them interviews. So yeah.
Shout out to the players and coaches too.
Okay, my boy Van say work. Okay. He went to practice in the scrimmage.
Yeah, he good.
Van good in my book. Van good in my book.
He don't even work during the week. He ain't been in number one practice in a scrimmage.
Hey, your own brother trying to say
it. It be your own people.
Dang.
Van, you got my vote, Van. You got my vote.
Yeah, my people.
What you got, Trill?
Well, he good, man. You know, Van, hey, it wouldn't be no golden ham without Van.
So Van good. Okay, we got next one. Say still might come, but Night Drive not good. That don't sound like you coming. You might be finna go off the island.
Hold on.
Okay.
How far you got to drive? How many hours?
Yeah, let's see that. How many hours? My boy. Oh, it's gonna be a good one here. It's gonna be a good one here. We'll come back to that one. I'll be at the Final Four in the Houston. It's my boy Lee now.
Hey Lee, you my boy, but not.
All court ain't playing.
Yeah, Lee. Hold on. I'm gonna write up your switching paper.
Wait. We talking about the women's Final Four or the men's Final Four?
The men. I think you said the men. I think you're talking about
the men. Yeah, My boy Lee, my boy.
If it's the women, he good.
Yeah, if it's the women, okay. He good.
Okay, Lee. Yeah, we're gonna write up. We're gonna give you a 1 week suspension, Lee. 1 week suspension for Lee.
Yeah, 1 week. Yeah.
Who next? Okay. I come in. Okay, Miss Melissa. I have a broken leg. Oh. You good. 1871. You're the first lady.
I had surgery the day before spring game down there, and I still came.
Hey, Ben don't vote no more. None of
that. Okay. Hello. I'm missing something, y'all. He said 2 hours.
2 hours.
Oh, no. You gonna list two. Suspend it.
Suspend it 1 week.
Suspend it. You suspend it. Suspend it from the Brave Nation. Next up, Black. I can't make it. I'm in Missouri for work. We'll be trying to back.
Because he tried to say I wasn't coming before I even tried. Hell no.
Yo, Black.
See his ass.
Yeah. Black suspended. Let me see. Yeah, Black suspended for a week.
2 weeks. 2 weeks. Because he spoke for me. And I ain't even say why suspended. I wasn't coming.
Yep, you suspended for a week. Yep.
Knew what the spring game was. You fucking took off.
Chapter president suspended. Okay, who next? Had every intention, but my dad. Whoa. You good, bro.
You good.
Prayers to you. Prayers to you. You good.
Condolences, brother.
My condolences to you. Who else ain't coming? I know it's more y'all that ain't coming. Quinn Major. What you said earlier, Quinn? Hold on. Let me get to you.
I'm in Atlanta.
Yeah, that's my boy, too, but we ain't cutting nobody no slack.
Because I'm in Atlanta.
JJ, what you said, Melissa Leg, man?
Cause like, listen, I'm gonna tell you this. Me and Quinn was cool when we were on the yard, and that man traveled like a crazy. So, thumbs down.
He didn't even see the comments yet.
That man loved to drive. Thumbs down.
I gotta get to the comment. Hold on. Here we go. He says, because I'm in Atlanta, but I'm coming to three. Oh no. No. Yep. Quentin Major. Yep. You're gonna list.
Quentin I'm talking Major. About that man is a globe trotter.
Okay. Thumbs Quentin Major. Down. Suspend. How many weeks we giving Quentin?
Two.
2 weeks suspension.
No, you got to get more than that. He only making three games.
He coming to three games.
Oh, yeah. No, 3 games. So he gets suspended for each game he coming to. Three.
No,
three.
No, he's suspended indefinitely. Like, he's suspended indefinitely. Indefinitely. Yeah, Quinn. Yeah. You been new about, how long you been knowing about this spring game? Uh-uh, we ain't giving no excuses.
All right.
We got, who else ain't coming? Let's go. Who else?
What else we got?
What is a Dreamville Festival?
Oh, that's J. Cole Festival. All right, J. Cole.
I'm not coming because I'm in North Carolina for the Dreamville Festival. Yep,
He ain't going to Alcorn.
Boogie, that's Boogie. Yep, And he a Kings fan. He a Kings fan. So,
he a
Bulls
fan?
Kings. So that's
like Sacramento?
Yeah. Indefinitely. Indefinitely.
Yeah, nah.
I ain't never indefinitely heard about
he can't get back on until the Kings make the playoffs. Not the play in. They got to make the playoffs.
Okay. Oh, my boy. Oh, my dog. Oh, my boy. Not my dog.
Hey, not my dog. Man.
Hey, do they have spaghetti with the catfish?
Not my dog. I can't suspend my dog. I got to be biased on this one.
No.
The teacher, you didn't want to take
it. Y'all gonna let me put that paperwork on my boy?
You chose catfish over the Brave Nation?
Dang.
Well, he might be from the parlay, though.
Bro, they making me do it, bro. We're gonna give you 2 weeks, bro.
Nah, give him a week, bro.
Give him a week. Okay. Give him a week. Let me see who else.
He say, who do we appeal these suspicions? Ain't no appeal.
Ain't no appeal.
Come on, guys. I'll be at 3 games. I have to fly in from DMV.
He is from far.
Let's see.
Take a day off his suspension.
Take a week off his suspension.
We'll knock a week off for that. Yep. We'll get a week off. Gee, we swept the. Oh, you want to talk? You want to talk? Hey, a year suspension? You want to talk crazy? How you suspend?
I do agree.
How you suspended and won't talk crazy? Hey, okay, you
tell them too, Hope.
Hey, we fifth in the West right now. So, and we got the best player in the league. So
I'm driving out.
We'll beat we just beat y'all last night.
Who?
Golden State.
Boy, y'all beat us. We had a 5-game road trip. We were tied.
I ain't got nothing to do with that. I just said
y'all
we beat
give
y'all
a week for DMV Jersey Falls. Yeah, hey, but Black, look, but Black, you know, you got bigger responsibility.
Yeah, you talking about the best, bro.
You, no, Black, you one of us. You gotta get. Black, yeah, you got bigger responsibility.
Mm-mm. Yeah, and I only gave you suspension because you told me I wasn't coming. I didn't even say if I was coming.
Put it on the map.
That man is funny, bro.
Yeah, he's funny. That's what we need to get on here. Fact. Oh my god, people think I'm crazy. Man, y'all just don't know the stuff I see. This man say, my god.
Hey, that man
that crazy.
Man, that man be on fire.
Boy, man, that man that crazy.
Black welcome me to the news real quick.
That man that crazy.
Oh boy.
Who else not coming? Come on, put it down in the comments.
Man, they scared to get the comment.
Come on,
you must submit a pitch. Man, chill out, bro. What the world?
What's wrong with Chris, man?
I'm reading some of these comments.
Come on in these comments. If you're not coming, if you are coming, let us know when you're coming to town. So, if you try to not say nothing,
hey,
I'm gonna call y'all.
The world wants to know: is Anthony Kane playing in the alumni game?
So they won't know. Where he at?
He on here. The world wants
what
to know.
What y'all sleeping on?
He's
stretching now.
Is he playing?
They need to be drinking. They need to be hydrating. That's y'all need to be. Y'all need to be hydrating right now, okay? Because we ain't got no insurance. Y'all gotta go to work. Y'all, right now, don't be trying to sue Alcorn.
He
better start stretching. You're going to work
like
Monday morning.
Okay,
you're
like
going to work
jobs
Monday morning.
Oh man.
Need to be getting ready to purchase your season tickets too.
Yeah, that's another thing. Purchase season tickets if you can. Hey, you say you need to use.
He say the helps crazy.
Man, you better get the stretching on my dog.
Alumni weekend, May 10th. May 10th, we in the building.
May 10th.
Whoa, Spiller, hold on, dog. Hold on, wait. You not
said,
playing?
That's why I'm not playing.
What you mean, Spiller? They might get you a suspension up, bro. But you not playing, that might get you suspension up, bro. You everybody want to see. Let me get my pen out, man.
Come on, I don't know about that, bro.
Two weeks, bro.
Hey,
he was our main event ticket seller.
Yeah, he was our headliner.
He put out last minute. You can come over there and kick it with me.
Now he want to be the easy one.
Yeah. We'll give him 2 weeks.
Hey, Van, you ought to feel playing. That man threw you away for Spiller, bro. Your own brother.
That's crazy. Your own people, dog.
Parking passes. Require season tickets too this year.
Yep.
My guy Blake. I know Blake gonna be there Friday through Sunday.
Yes, sir.
Hey, G, what Blue been, man? We ain't seen Blue in a minute, bro.
He gonna be there. Blue gonna be there.
Yeah, I watched it yesterday.
Okay. He gonna be there. Blue. Cool. For y'all that don't know, the Blue Bloods podcast. He covers all FCS. He will be in attendance covering the Alcorn State 2024 spring game. And you know, yes, we might try to have him over there and give him some fish.
Yeah, I hate I'm missing, man.
Hey, man, y'all 40?
Damn, Benny, you 40?
Bro. Damn, I tried to tell.
Hey, we didn't know that, bro.
Ooh, I'm gonna go ahead and take a suspension off. I'm gonna take a week off this suspension. Ooh, I'm gonna take a week off. We need just 1 week. I'm gonna take a week off. I ain't know you was 40. I ain't know you was 40, Spiller. I ain't gonna know, you know. So I'm gonna take a week off there.
Running that fucking 40 like Arthur Young, cuz.
Who else not coming? I got my pen in my hand. Who else not coming? It ain't no excuse. You ain't got nothing to do. Ain't nothing else going on in the world.
You can get you some food while you're there.
Come on down. It is free. Y'all be complaining about. Come to the free stuff. It's free. Even though if it was me, I'd make y'all pay, but it's free. It's free, now. It's free. So come on down.
Man, we're going to have a good time.
Not to me, Joe.
Nah. Y'all just understand. I never knew how old Benny was, bro. That's just
yeah, I didn't know what he was born. I was sorry. Can we get off this subject?
My bad, bro. But I just didn't know you were 40, bro. That's all.
Will porta potties be available?
40 plus.
Yes, they will. Well, I don't know. I don't know if he said spring game. I don't want to say they will. They don't. I don't want to say they will and they don't. So I really don't know. Good question. Really good
y'all
question.
Y'all ain't old, man. Y'all seasoned.
Nah, man. 40 ain't old.
True.
I am the baby of the show, huh?
Yeah. For all y'all that said, make sure y'all like the stream, share the stream. If you're watching on Facebook, I meant to tell y'all to share it on y'all pages there. Share it and trying to have a bigger Facebook presence now, not just on YouTube. So if you're watching on Facebook, do your boy a favor and just hit the share button. And share for let's make this thing big every week.
Oh man. Benny, turn your comments off, bro.
Benny,
turn your comments. Don't look at the comments.
Ooh, Will, you better stop. I can say, watch yourself, Shay. Not to say we cool, but you better watch them now.
Whoa. Yeah, let's
we were just
there for the honor ceremony. They drive from Georgia. So wait, So that sound like you're not coming.
Yep.
Yeah, to me that sound like you're not coming. Let me know.
2 weeks.
Come on, let me know. It sound like you're not coming.
Who you talking about?
Martinez.
Martinez.
Don't that sound like y'all? They not coming?
No, nope. Yeah, that's what it sound like to me.
I'm going
to
start writing up his write up.
Hold on. We were just there. 325. The drive from Georgia is no joke.
Sound like a suspension to me.
Yeah, it sound like a suspension.
That sound like a year suspension.
Ooh, look. No answer.
A year.
Shaking my head.
Oh yeah, just for no answer. A year.
Yeah, for no answer. Yep, come on the list. Yep, yep. Made the list.
You could have made some up, but you
should. You should just say you're gonna be there.
Yep.
Yep. Come on the list.
A year.
Come a year on, for no on the list. Come on the list. Let me see. Can't make it. Whoa! There we go.
Okay. 6 months.
Six months for making us stall for so long. Huh? 6 months suspension from the Brave Nation. 6 months.
Oh man.
When I stayed in Joseph J. Favorite home game.
We talking about now. What have you done for me lately? That's what we talking about. What have you done?
Yeah, my boy trying to get that suspension. My boy trying to get that suspension. Suspension.
Gee, what you drinking, man? Suspension just kicked G tail, dog.
Hey, this episode is brought to you by that tea.
Suspension just kicked G tail, man.
Bro, we've been getting high and kicked by all day.
Suspension just texted Southern, you dog.
Oh man.
I didn't look. I never corrected. I just stopped trying. I said, I'm just going to stop saying it.
Oh man, that was funny.
Boy, so he's trying to appeal.
My head. I didn't miss a game last year. Okay.
Didn't miss a game last year. Okay, good.
That has a point.
You got a point.
Wait, 3 months.
But you're still on the list. I'm making them list. You're still on the list. Wait, where is it?
I tell you what.
Community service.
Cash after 1871 connection, but we'll lift your suspension.
And you gotta go to community service.
Yeah, you gotta share
the stream.
Yeah, you're gonna be.
Cash after 1871 collective, and we'll lift your suspension.
Yeah, lift your suspension. There you go.
That's for anybody. Share and like the stream. You get reduced.
Yeah, we're going to have a good time for all y'all that don't come. I love the spring game atmosphere because it's that time where it's mostly people that love Alcorn going to be at the spring game. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It ain't the people that deal with it, worry about the outfit. You know how you get to some game that everybody that came with the outfit because of the party. this is people that love Alcorn, gonna be there fellowshipping. It's gonna be a lot of family. You see people that you ain't seen since football season. You know what I'm saying? So a big family fellowship. And we're gonna kick it after the game real hard, before the game, and have some fun.
So we're gonna do a vlog.
We're gonna vlog it. We're gonna vlog it, and you know, have some fun. Talk to some people, get some predictions, what they think about the spring game. Get some clips of the spring game. Just let people, you know, get their thoughts and predictions. Since don't nobody ever want to call in or come on the show, you know, what y'all put on the video.
I hate ain't going to be there, bro. I was looking forward. I had booked my hotel in Vicksburg the night before and everything, man. I was so excited.
Man, listen, that stuff happens, man. Hey, look, yeah, quick question before we leave, everybody in the chat. So we was at the scrimmage, and Hope said, "Let's run the 40 and race." So look,
who said that?
You said that it was.
No hell,
you.
I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I was been drunk.
You probably was. But anyway, so if y'all had to choose out of us four in a 40-yard race, who y'all think will win? Put it in the comments.
Hey, listen. I don't think people realize, bro. I got long legs. Like, I'm taller than these dudes.
Don't answer this wrong now.
I'm gonna win.
Come on now. Don't answer this wrong now. What time the game again? 2:00. You gonna be there?
You
gonna be there, Miss Alpha? You gonna be there?
I'm actually worried about Benny. That's the only person I'm worried about. I ain't worried about y'all too.
Don't get shot now.
I ain't worried about y'all.
Hey, I got y'all. You know, I might slack up and let y'all keep it close. There you go. Ooh,
you get some. See? Hope, yep.
Devin.
Hello, Devin. Devin. Okay. Might win, bro.
Okay, how far you say this is again?
40 yards.
Go, 40 yards.
40.
40 man, yards. You know what's up?
Kane, that's my dog.
Kane, I thought we were better than that, man.
Man, he put me last, man. Willie put me last. God, hey. Hold on. I got something to say.
That's what I'm saying, man. Like,
just making sure you ain't changing on.
Don't worry about his Benny. That's it.
These legs.
Yeah, I got that easy. I might backpedal on mine. I might backpedal.
I like that. I like that
theory, bro. Y'all gotta give me about a week or two to stretch.
Yeah, I gotta stretch, cause
yeah, we gotta stretch for a while.
You talking about hamstrings and stuff getting pulled?
Quad. I'll tell you
everything. 40 yards.
40 yards.
Everything good. Cool.
Oh man.
40 yards. Now if we had a 3-point shootout, y'all ain't got no chance.
Me basketball trail. Come on, bro.
Come on now. Do I need to show y'all? Y'all know bro. I won a 3-point challenge last year at the in Birmingham at the SWAC championship. And I won a cell phone.
I don't care about none of that.
You better ask Phillip.
Y'all ain't trying to see me on that court, dog. I'm sorry. I wouldn't even go in the post. I'm shooting. Hey, if I go in the post, it's over with.
It's only one way to find
man,
out.
Come
bro.
On.
You better bro, I'm 6'3".
I don't care.
That ain't got nothing
to do with me in the post.
That ain't got nothing to you. That means you ain't gonna better stay in front of me though. You ain't gonna better move them legs like that. You ain't gonna better move them legs like that.
I ain't got you. I got long horns, bro.
What position did you play in high school, Hope?
Huh?
What position did you play in high school?
In basketball?
Yeah.
Forward.
Trail, what position you play?
Two guard.
What you play, G?
One, point. Of course, point.
I played point and guard.
I ain't played nothing but the point.
Newsom K, you better tell him now, man.
Man, y'all boys, listen, bro. So we're gonna play?
You better tell him.
21. We'll see who wins.
Man, I'm trying to tell you. Hey.
I'm gonna lock you up. Come on now. Y'all talking crazy now.
I'm Draymond on that court.
Pull up that comment, G.
Which one?
Pull up news and comment now.
That's your boy. Of course, he's gonna vouch for you.
Ooh.
Pull up that comment now.
You gotta get it out first. I'm
yeah, that's too. That's too much. Wilkinson sound counting. A me counting too much agreeing right now. I don't know
hey,
look.
Hey,
Trey, you gotta get it off. I'm swatting it.
Bruh, stop.
I'm swatting it.
I shoot better with a hand in my face.
The hand gonna be on the ball. I'm swatting it.
Man, you gotta better get them. I'm coming around them screens slow. like Steph.
Hey, look. I ain't that slow, bro.
I hate bragging. Yeah. If it's three things I can do, that's play fish. And shoot basketball.
I told y'all. I know fish.
We should compete against other HCU podcasts and basketball. I think we'll win.
Yeah, I'm not losing to nobody else. I'm sorry. That ain't
happening. Yeah.
That's it, Kay. Kay, stay trail beans.
He said pause. Oh, hey, chill out, Black.
No, Diddy.
Not my boy Diddy and up there.
No Diddy.
Hey, we can make that happen. We can go to the Blacktop Saturday, man. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't gonna be that Saturday, man. Listen.
You already lost, so it don't matter if you're there or not.
Bro, you not messing with me on the court, dog. You just
man, I'm telling y'all.
All right.
Man, he lost the bad feeling in basketball.
First of all, no, I didn't play. I didn't live in Columbia at that time, bro. No, I did not. Bro, I averaged 20 my freshman year, bro. What y'all talking about?
I'm telling you, dog. Listen.
And then after that, it went from 20 to 10 to 8. I regret.
It ain't gonna happen, cuz.
I ain't gonna lie, Trill.
Mr. Lee, Mr. Lee, yes, sir. They played at Liberty, man. My dad and my mom. What you say about fishing?
I said, Trail, you probably the only person to be my competition fishing. I don't think G can fish.
Hell no. I fish at the fishing mark. Let me get that one right there. I'll be tapping on the thing. Like, let me get that one. No, give me that big feet leg.
You might beat me in fishing.
A fishing competition would definitely be fun.
Yeah, Trail gonna win.
I'm gonna just watch.
Better fisherman I am.
G, I'm gonna be watching with you.
I don't know.
Wait, you don't fish, business? You from Bassfield?
I can't fish, bro.
Y'all ain't got no family pond in Bassfield, dude.
I got a pond behind my house and still.
What's it?
What, for real? Can we call it fish?
Yeah, I ain't never caught no dog. No. I ain't never caught a fish out of there.
Bro, okay, I'm gonna hit you up and I'm coming. Now, if I catch a fish out your own pond, we gotta talk.
Rule number one, Ben, you should never tell people who fish. You got a pond in your backyard.
Bass, brim.
You got bass? Oh, I'm coming fish. That's all I needed to hear.
Yep.
Yeah, Ben, don't ever tell people who fish you got a pond in your backyard. Because you ain't gonna never get rid of them.
Nah, but I got no problem with it. I'll pay you to fish,
I ain't gonna catch them.
Yeah, I ain't even gonna try.
Shoot,
what? Let me tell y'all something. This is gonna blow y'all mind. I ain't never been fishing.
Really?
Ever in my life. I've never held a fishing reel. Ever in my life. I wouldn't know what to do. I'd be like, I've never touched one. Never.
Bro, I'm telling you, once you start doing it, G, you'll get hooked on it, bro. It's cool. It ain't about catching fish, it's just being out.
Yeah, it's a relaxation, man.
That ain't true. I don't enjoy it at all.
I've been seeing his comments, man. That man funny as hell. That man down for the weed.
Hey, now, Spiller can fish too, though, man. Y'all don't let him fool you.
We done went from fishing to
fishing at all.
We've been something everywhere tonight.
we done went everywhere. Right. This is one of them shows. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel. Make sure y'all come out and support the Spring Game. The 1871 collective.com. We got 89 people on here right now. Make sure everybody at least hit the website and think about subscribing to the 1871 collective.
Man went fishing and you hadn't been.
No, I done been fishing. I can't catch him.
Oh, I mean, that happened, bro. You went on some bad days.
Everything bad.
I ain't
never caught him.
Never. Not one time, dog.
G ain't from Louisville for real.
Not one time, dog. I ain't never been fishing.
So, Benny, do me a favor. Get you a reel and rod. Go to Walmart and buy you a pack of green and red lizards.
Got that.
And throw your. And you ain't caught a fish?
Mm-mm, my wife can catch them. I can't do it.
But you actually fished before, right?
That's what I'm saying.
So what?
You actually fished before, right?
Yeah, like I just can't. Oh, yeah. I can't catch.
It ain't happen, bro. I'll be honest, Benny. I ain't caught a fish this year yet.
Bro, I'm waiting for another fish.
But I ain't been. Chill out, G. I'm trying to make it feel better. I won't be fishing more. Hey,
I went through in the lake at all, called 5 minutes and caught that fish I sent y'all.
Yeah, I wouldn't know what to throw in the lake. I've been through the wrong part. I've been through the part you hole in the lake. You look around. So another thing. Okay, one before we go. What we drinking Saturday?
I got this self-made.
On me.
I got this self-made.
Hey, true. Hey, real talk.
My boy. Go ahead.
You got the shine, bro? I'm about to get something from you.
My boy.
Yeah,
listen.
Get the shine from you, bro.
Let me tell you, my boy. I gotta tell you, I believe my boy, Devin Hurt. Because every time we talk about man. Saturday, look, you gotta check his face. He's just like,
he's sitting
it out. Yo,
I wish they said about Saturday. Like,
man, I'm hurting, dog. I'm hurting.
I said, what we drinking Saturday the whole time, Devin, like this.
Man, I'm hurting, dog. I am.
You still can make it. You still can make it.
If I did try to make it, bro, it'd be after the spring game.
We'll be out there.
But I'm gonna come in with a suit on, bro. Like,
what time is
time to change?
Hey, you presidential,
dog. You want me to drink in a suit?
What time is the funeral?
11. And it's like 2.5 hours away. It's in Greenwood, so it's 2.5 hours away.
Oh yeah, you can make that.
Nah, man.
It'll start the 2.
If I show up, it ain't because I told y'all I show up. I'm just going to call y'all when I get on campus. Y'all might not even get cool that call.
I'm cool with that. We can do that.
This man Adrian funny as hell, bro. This man say you get the pre-roll. He over here talking about weed. I ain't finna incriminate myself on here talking to you.
Gee, I ain't never seen them people down there that quiet, man. This quiet.
Listen, they just stripped everything from them. Everything gone. The flag, the flame is gone. The feeling is gone. I told them this day was coming.
They got the best coach in the SWAC now.
I told them this day was coming.
I've been drinking.
Blake, I got a cane pole. That don't work neither.
Hey, Benny, go get you some cricket.
I've been drinking too much. Let me put this down.
You heard me, Benny?
Huh?
Get you a cork and some cricket and throw it in your pun.
I got all that.
You gonna pre-feed them?
Yeah, I did that.
Hey, get some fish feed. Ben, this is how you cheat, bro. Listen,
no, man, that's cheap.
Get some fish feed and feed them at one time, like in the afternoon. Every day at the same time.
I did all that. I can see the fish right
damn,
there.
Damn, Ben, you still can't catch no fish?
I still could catch
them. Damn, Ben.
Yeah, something wrong. I'm coming fishing, Ben. I'm gonna text you and let you know. So y'all just tune in to the group best. I'll be like, man, I done came to Ben's house for the first time and caught fish in 5 minutes.
I told y'all, look,
bad. It didn't happen so many times.
Listen, Trey, I love to fish.
I love fishing, bro. I will leave work going fishing.
I'm gonna tell Trey, I love to fish and my bell sausage.
Say, you got a pun? I don't care if you wherever you at. I go fish that too.
Yeah, she do, Trey.
She do?
Yep.
Man. But anyway, y'all just enjoy yourself Saturday, bro. You know what I'm saying? Y'all be safe.
You know what? You need to get your priorities straight.
Man, this man is hell, bro. This man is hell.
God, dog, man.
This man is hell, bro. But I ain't gonna lie, I needed this laugh, bro. Like, I really did. Y'all boys hilarious, bro.
Oh, my God.
Look at KG. That boy loves fishing for real.
Oh, man.
Y'all boys hell, man. Hey, man, get your priorities straight. God damn. That's why you can't fish, nigga. Shit.
Hey, my boy got hot,
man. Boy, y'all. Oh,
Oh. Oh man.
Oh. Oh my god.
And I mean that with all love.
Oh my, what y'all is clouded. Oh my god.
Hey, bro.
Boy, I sound like that kid.
All right, so vlogs, I already see vlogs at games are gonna be crazy.
Vlogs after big wins. Wait, before we go, let's do one more exercise. Let's do one more exercise. Let's do one more exercise. Let's do one more exercise before we go. Before we go. I forgot I put this up here. I'm gonna take this. How many games we coming to?
Okay. Vanderbilt. 1, 2, 3.
1, 2. 4.
It depends on my work schedule too though.
5, 6.
How many games we coming to?
Hold
on. Drop it in the comments as well.
I like to make at least 8 of them.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 9 for me. Possibly 10, but definitely 9. I'm going to miss the UAB game. I'm going to miss the McNeese game. That's my wife's birthday weekend.
Oh, yeah. See.
I think that might be the – and possibly the Graham game, but I'm trying to get out of that one.
AG, quick question. Mm-hmm. How you feel about McNeese? What's the vibe of McNeese? I only been there once. Like,
I've been every time. It's like a regular PWI with no fans. We gonna have more fans than they is.
That's how it was the one time I went. It wasn't really that many fans, but I ain't stay there. I drove in and drove out, so I'm probably gonna stay this time.
Hope it's good to go because we gonna win. Yeah, last time we went there, we won.
Yeah,
with 10 sets. Yeah.
So
definitely going to Vanderbilt.
Yeah,
Valley gonna be. Home game. I'm gonna go to Valley and come back home.
Listen,
first home game. What we doing, y'all?
Listen. I'm gonna give y'all my. I'm not going to Valley. That's the one game. I'm not going to Valley. I'm not going to Valley. I tell everybody. I'm not. Listen.
I don't like going to Valley either, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you.
I'm not going to Valley.
I gotta go to Valley, man. That's my dad's school. I'm gonna take my daddy. You know what I'm saying?
That might be why we be struggling with Valley because G won't come to the game.
Yeah. Yeah, default.
I hope Coach T's.
Hey, y'all. Hey, look. Oh, y'all might not get this reference. He's from the other ASU. That's why he's saying it.
Alabama State.
Yeah.
Okay, I get it. It took you a minute.
Yeah, hey, you know, I'm kind of slow, bro.
We can't bother who don't want to be bothered.
That's a word.
Hey, he my classmate.
I forgot about that. You know what?
They are
Mr. Kincaid. If they do that, they might give me the 12.
Yeah. If they do that, I'm definitely going to Prairie View, bro.
You know what? People. The first one I said I wasn't going to was Valley, and the second one was iffy for me was PV.
I'm going to PV. I'm not going to Mobile.
I'm probably going to be there. I always say I'm iffy, but I probably still go.
I'm not going to Mobile. Nope.
I'm not going to Grambling.
Man, Host, you gotta come to Mobile, man.
Bro, I
don't believe that, Ben. I think Ben gonna come to Graham.
I do not think he'll end up Alabama, coming. Alabama, period. I like no part of Alabama.
That Graham game, I'm trying to get out of going to a win.
I ain't got no. Got to be at the Gremlin. It's right down the street from me, bro.
Yeah, he got to be there.
Host, you gotta come to Mobile.
I can't do it. I'm sorry.
Southern definitely gonna be there for Southern. Well, who else we got?
Y'all say y'all not y'all, Alabama State. I think Alabama's gonna be a big game. Yeah, I think it'll be a big game though.
I'm down, bro.
That ain't nobody.
That could be a swag championship game. Preview.
You gonna be on TV?
Come on, Hope.
Bro, I do not mess with Mobile, bro.
Hey, that was Montgomery.
It's true. It was.
I was saying how you don't mess with Mobile,
bro.
Hey, Hope, drive to Liberty and ride with me, bro.
Nah, so here's the thing. And y'all be like, damn, Hope, that was a long ass time ago.
Tell it.
I got a story, bro. Y'all remember when the Mississippi Alabama game used to be in Mobile? I don't know if y'all remember that. Well, they had all stars between Mississippi and Alabama playing in the game.
Go ahead.
Damn, bro, you had to put me on front street. Hey, take me off the camera, bro. I ain't even tell the story now.
Go ahead.
I'm done, bro. I'm done. Nah, I'm gonna come, bro. I'm just bullshitting. I'm coming.
But yeah, I'm gonna miss the UAB game, man.
Yeah, but hold on. I might not have to work that day. If I don't have to, I might can.
I don't want to take off two Fridays in a row.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. And y'all don't kill me, but I'm going to another game that Thursday because it's right in my hometown. I got free tickets, bro. What are you talking about? And I'm taking some kids.
Where your paper, NG?
I'm taking some kids to the game, bro.
Yeah,
no, bro, listen. I'm a mentor, bro. I'm taking some kids to the game.
What game?
This for the church.
What game you going to? Okay, this we going to decide it. What game?
I'm sitting on their side, on the other side, though.
What game?
I ain't telling y'all. ULM and Jack State. ULM and Jack State, bro. But I'm sitting on ULM side. Bro, it's right down the street from my house.
Will you be wearing blue?
No, I'm wearing maroon. It's close to purple.
You better wear purple than gold.
It's close to purple.
Put the collector's hat on.
You really doing that?
Huh?
You really gonna do that?
Bro, the hospital I work at give away free tickets, bro, and they give away like 10 tickets to the game. And I was kids from my church to go.
You know what? Just because it's church,
I would pay not to go to the game.
That's what I was about to say.
It's for the Lord.
Doing it.
It's for the Lord, you guys. It's for the Lord.
God, dog.
Man.
And we what all in BR, though, right?
Everybody talk about.
We all were.
We all in BR, though, right?
Nah, somebody said suspend them. G,
hey, bro.
Suspend
him for that. Nah, man. Come on. Birmingham versus right down the street from my house. Come on, bro.
Nah, G. See, I know you ain't asked that.
Yeah, I didn't know if we all going to be in Because I'm going to tell y'all now, we're going to be in a parade. I told this on the show. Did I tell the people on the show yet?
You ain't told about it yet.
I've been talking too much.
You said it,
nah. I said it, you know. We're going to be in a parade, so you know what I'm saying? We're going to do our thing. I love to beat Southern. And get, ooh, that's going
to
be.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Hey, that's going to be the game, bro. You know what? I just can't wait, bro. Just the noise talking.
Only thing about that is...
You're right. You're right.
Hey, I tell you what. Tell J-Max and Al, get them two more people and play us in a 4-on-4 basketball game.
Oh, yeah. We whooping them, bro. They ain't scoring. Because the only person I worry about is J-Max. He a little tall. He's shorter than me, but he tall.
Yeah, you'll match up with him good.
Yeah. Al. Beanie, I think you got Al. You got Al.
Hey, listen. I'm gonna be on my top of the game. You know, some games I'll be a little turned down. Some games I'll be a little turned up. Yeah. Southern game? Oh, come on.
Hey, hold up. All week. You Jackson State game in 2021?
You remember that?
Ooh.
Hey, I'm letting y'all know I'm doing IVs for the Southern game, all right? I'm doing IVs for the Southern game.
The Jackson game, I ain't remember who I talked to. I was on another level.
Oh, I know.
I was down there screaming and hollering at Travis Hunter.
I don't give a damn by fault.
This man G was like, "That you? This my nigga. This my nigga." And my mom was like, "Apparently that's your nigga."
So they did a Swag and a Fool show after the game. And G was like, "Trey, did I see you?" J-Mass was like, "Man, you held the whole conversation with this man."
Ooh, I was lit. But right for us, you know, I'll be lit. Then when we lose, it all go away.
That's how it was homecoming.
When we lose, it all go away.
Right, quick.
Trey gonna drop 40. Dang, everybody say Trey. Hey,
I'm telling you, man. But ask somebody.
Hey, look, you better shoot it. I'm gonna pass it to you. You better shoot it.
Yeah, I'm gonna get it to you now.
Yeah, we're gonna get it to you. I ain't no ball hawk.
I can't fly like I used to. I used to fly a little bit, but shoot, I don't know if I can touch the rim no more.
It's cool. Yeah. I ain't dunked in a while myself.
Yes, sir. Oh, I ain't never dunked, no.
G, I feel like you play football, though, didn't you?
Yeah, both. I play both.
You play DB?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How you do that? I told you that.
No, I can tell, bro.
Oh.
Like, you don't look like you play running back or nothing like that.
He don't know. Running back.
That ain't no joke.
Some water. All right, it's some over here.
Hey, running back, you gonna get your body beat up for real.
Yeah, I ain't doing all that.
It's been 2 hours.
Yeah, man, it's been 2 hours, bro. So, any closing words? What we can look for at the spring game? Thing y'all want to talk about before we get out of here? Come to the spring game. I don't know what I'm gonna make it just yet, but I'm
coming. And come find us, man.
Yeah, come find us.
Let us know who you are.
And I also put on live for me when y'all get there. Just think of me.
I ain't finna run my battery down for you.
Man, that's crazy, bro. I thought we were boys, man. That's crazy.
Man, you know I got you, man.
Y'all see how the group chat go. Everybody gets me.
Hey, I'm a fade time. just hang up when you view.
All right, bet.
Man, yeah, before y'all go, make sure y'all like the stream, share the stream. If you can, I'm gonna let y'all make it this week with a giving. 1871collective.com. Next week we're gonna put the cash app. Y'all gonna be donating to 1871 Collective. We'll do that next week because we're gonna wait 2 hours. So until next time, if y'all ain't got nothing else,
out dog.
The Golden Hair Review. Big Bad Braves by 40 this weekend. We out.